stop here for a moment. Look at that then. I don't know what pass that is, but that's not one we came up. The trouble with picking up somebody else's route is that he also had a huge how to get to it from wherever he was. So I had to delete all that stuff. And then you're not quite sure what you've left yourself with, but... Oh, did I just say that out loud? Just looking at those horns. I don't know what that's about. Oh, did I tell you that in Andamat, it's the there's a national yodeling competition going on, which could be fun. Don't know whether you're fans of yodeling. I think once I get in the swing of it, it'll be okay. It's just getting in the swing. Careful not to be leaning. Gear is low. Somebody suggested a couple of times changing the front sprocket. I don't know what else it would do to the rest of the bike's gearing then. Oh my, really? You're walking with a trailer? Cyclist looking to overtake everybody. Oh, but look at the view. Well, you look at the view, I'll watch the road. Gear on this one. Maybe second gear is the answer. Unfortunate. Second, I think. Right, okay, let's try this one on second. Second everything's okay. Let's use second from now on then. Let's just see if we can do that. But it's stunning up here. We're at 2,119 meters at the moment. Just noticed when I came out of that little checking the altitude that it said that there was a ferry required to link these things together. I'm hoping that is not the case. Still climbing. These cyclists amaze me. Absolute utter respect for anybody who can cycle these things. In fact, respect for anybody who cycles or walks or does any form of exercise, really. It's all too easy to neglect our physical health. Doesn't look as if you can get access to it. I'd restock my water. Don't those big concrete bollards make you feel so much safer? Well, this looks very slow. Okay, lean the bike, not the person. Yep, good. You want to go, not the bit that drops off. Every bend is a photo opportunity, really. Of course, it'd be harder overtaking these cyclists going down the hill. Wow. I think that's the top. 2,432 meters. And there's a road. I assume that's the road we're going to be going down over there. Anyway, let's just get past these cyclists nicely. Again, I don't know whether you can see Garmin here, but it's showing the where we're going. Well, I'm just gonna see if I can pull in over here somewhere safely. And just look at that, and the river winding along with it. That is just fantastic. Bit of a photo opportunity, I think. I hope. Look at that. Beautiful. like it's one of those extended hairpins where they've kicked out a bit over the top. In the bike, not the person. In my case, anyway. Waterfall over there in the distance. And it's a flow of water going downwards. Well, water does go downwards. Grimsel is the one that's next. So this is the start of the Grimsel Pass. So that was the Furka. This is Grimsel. I still can't remember the name of the third one. Let's try this one in second. So I don't know whether you can see that wiggly line. That's the route. Anyway. Lots of hairpins, that's what we're here for. I am sort of questioning after all these. Whether do I really need to do the Stelvio? Is Stelvio any more interesting, more challenging, easier? It's just a famous pass. But motorcyclists do. So this is the Grimsel Pass, 2164 meters, all laid out for motorcycle parking. I'm not actually stopping. That. turned up the top, yeah. Just gone 12. Heaving bikes. Oh, look at the colours there. Hold on. Just have to stop for a moment. Sort of like a hue of green. Just lying in the cool. I'm not sure what the colours come out like. You know, there's different resolutions, monitors, all the rest of it. But there's definite hue of green. And the water below, definitely green. Beautiful reflection of the mountain in one of the pools there. Time to stop. That's a definite photo call there. In the distance over there, it's actually a waterfall. It is flowing. Dam there, so it's sort of a series of dams being constructed. Side of that dam wall. I don't mean that dam wall, I mean the wall of the dam. Reflection. I wonder if that will come out. Gorgeous. Gorgeous. No way to stop, take a photo. I can try doing a GoPro photo, but I'm not sure how well that would work either. Let's try it. Tannin. The town is called Utannin. Quite pretty. Facilities. Hotels. Lots of people walking. I bet that's fun, a little Lotus 7. We've still got 75 kilometres of this route to do. We've done 50 kilometres of it, and I've used two GoPro batteries, and I've only got this one and another one because obviously I lost my GoPro batteries. Bit more roadworks going on, traffic light controlled, so they're only allowing one way through at a time. Just a very small stretch. Looks like a bit of an industry going on here. I guess it's hydroelectric. This GPX has got it right, yeah. It's saying I'm turning right just up here. That's the system. Again, a slight change in the scenery. We're climbing again, but it's very wooded here. And as we're climbing, it's getting cooler as well. Just stopping in a little town. We're a bit higher now. Tea room's over there. It's open. I've just stopped for lunch at a place called Gadmen. And I just got to show you the views that this place has. So that's out the back, and then the front. Anyway, on with the next pass. I think we've still got the Susten pass to do. I hope so anyway. Catch you later. Just a post-lunch stroll, really. Just enjoying the slightly cooler temperature up here and the dramatic scenery. This one looks particularly interesting, this hairpin. And second. Yep, it's fine. A view of the valley the other side. Excuse me. Yes, so I stopped for lunch there. And I had a bratwurst, like a hot dog, and some chips, a glass of Coke, and a glass of water. I think I probably, you know, 500 mil each. And came to 24 Swiss francs, which is about 24 euros, about 20 pounds. A bit expensive for a hot dog and chips, really. But look at that waterfall there, it's just falling off. It's a lot of water. Susten Pass. Yeah, so this is the final pass. So we did the Furka, Grimsel, and now this is Susten. So three passes within sort of like an 80-mile loop, 120 kilometres or wherever it is. So, of course, the downside is you've got to get here, which is not a downside. I have to remember though that these passes are only open a few months of the year. I'm just going to pull in here, just hope these bikes behind me don't go too far. You can see there the glacier, very near the top, the blue. Don't know how thick it's meant to be or how thick it was 20 years ago at this time of year, but I would imagine it's on the decrease, sadly. Big block of snow. Nice, packed ice. View right along the valley. For those of you who can make it here, do try. For those of you who can't, I can't express how fabulous it is, the depths and the smell. It's clean air, quite quiet of course, apart from motorcycles and wind noise and the crash helmet. There's bird song. But, you know, just the whole smells and sounds, the whole sensory thing is just astounding. Okay, I've plumbed in the place we're staying at, and it's saying it's 55 kilometres from here. It doesn't mention anything about a ferry being required, and I've told it to use the adventurer's routing. There we go.